Good morning. News bulletin for today is new technique for easier cervical cancer screening. Duke University researchers have developed a handheld device for cervical cancer screening that promises to do away with uncomfortable speculums and high-cost colposcopes. If widely adopted, women might even use device to self-screen, transforming screening and cure rates in low-income countries and regions of the US where cervical cancer is most prevalent. The researchers are now working on clinical trials to see how their design stacks up against the traditional colposcopy used with a speculum. By using both methods to visualize the cervix, the researchers will be able to make a direct comparison. A tissue scanner for psoriasis patients. A newly developed tissue scanner by a team of researchers from the Technical University of Munich allows looking under the skin of psoriasis patients. This provides clinically relevant information such as the structure of skin layers and blood levels without the need for contrast agents or radiation exposure. Psoriasis is an inflammatory skin disease that is characterized by small to palm-sized patches of severely scaling skin. The researchers plan to use the same imaging method to assess other diseases such as skin cancer or diabetes in the future. New strategy developed for pain relief. Researchers from Monash University have developed a new drug delivery strategy to block pain within the nerve cells in what could be a major development of an immediate and long-lasting treatment for pain. Researchers found out that if NK1 receptor protein, which mediates pain transmission, is blocked once it enters the nerve cell, it is possible to suppress pain more effectively. Drugs have been developed that specifically target NK1 receptors within the nerve cell, but the challenge is now to translate the technology to human clinical trials. New method to build better brains. A team of researchers at the Institute of Molecular Biotechnology of the Austrian Academy of Sciences had pioneered brain organoid technology, that is to cultivate three-dimensional brain-like structures in a dish, a few years ago. Recently, scientists from Cambridge and Vienna presented a new method that combines the organoid method with bioengineering. This novel technology can be used for studying a broader array of neurological diseases where neuronal positioning is thought to be affected, including epilepsy, autism, and schizophrenia. Thank you.